Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Hazina Natasha binti Ahmad 255420 for my case study. So the meaning of back-to-back letter of credit. Letter of credit consists of two letters that are used together to fund a loan. So it can state that the retailer then collects the letter of credit from the customer to guarantee proper payment, and then the same retailer gives the letter of credit to someone from which he sells items or products. So the important point, what I understand is Norris would act as a buyer, buy a mechanical products for 500 units, 500,000. From a supplier named Bamboo in Christchurch, New Zealand. But then Bamboo does not have enough supply for 2,000 units of that product. So Bamboo acts as a middleman and enter to a contract with Chuck Norris in Sydney, Australia, who act as a supplier to supply the balance insufficient products. So this is the flow. Issue and settle back-to-back credit letter of credit. So the first one is new NW act as a buyer, one mechanical products of 5,000 units. So NW know BL in New Zealand can supply that mechanical products for 50 New Zealand currency. So NW agree with that price. So for the number two, NW require his bank ANZ Bank, which is from the buyer bank, to issue letter of credit for 5,000 units, which is for $250,000 for NW's favor. So for the number three, the bank issued the letter of credit to BL, which is advised through a bank in New Zealand. So for the flow for number four, BL does not enough supply all the mechanical products. So BL wants to buy 8,000 units using $50 currency, which is New Zealand currency, from to buy a product from CNL in Australia. So for the flow number 5, BL require his bank, which is a New Zealand bank, to issue payment instructions or letter of for the balance 2,000 units from NW using the remaining amount of letter of credit, which is 2,000 units. So for the flow number 6, the bank credit to CNL, which advised through bank in Australia, which act as a advisory bank. So for number 7, which is from advising bank in Australia to CNL, number 7. Sorry, I'm typo. So CNL ships the 2,000. Oh, sorry, it's not typo. From CNL to NW buyer. So CNL ships the 2,000 units of mechanical products directly to NW, and BL also ships another 3,000 units of that mechanical products to NW. That's a flow for number 7. So I will continue. So this is the next step, which is how to settle that letter of credit. So for number 8, flow number 8, CNL sends relay to Australia banks. And then number 9, New Zealand bank will pay the presenting, number 9, from that Australia bank. Australia bank will present the documents to issuing bank, which is New Zealand bank. And then for presenting bank, which is Australia bank, after the document is compliance. So for the flow number 11, for flow number 11, CNL will get paid also. And then for 12.1 until 12.2, issuing bank, which is New Zealand bank, will notify BL of the arrival of documents and swap. They will swap back the documents like invoice, draft, bill of exchange. So for 13.1, New Zealand send the documents to ANZ Bank, which is New NW Buyer Banks. So for 13.2, the documents will be present to NW for taking possession of the mechanical products. And then for number 14, floor number 14, NW needs to pay for their documents to NZ banks, either by financing or cash. There can be two options lah, financing or cash to have that mechanical products. So for number 15, which is last 15, which is last flow 50.1 and 50.2, payment then will be remitted to ANZ banks and finally be. So that's all for the for the. That's all for the flow. Yes, that's all for the flow. And next, for the conclusion, letter of credit has been an essential method for and improving the cash flow process. So this is the benefits of the letter of credit. So letter of credit may accepted several times as a negotiable device, rendering it the most versatile payment method. So the back-to-back letter of credit allows payments to subcontractors. That's all from me. Thank you.